from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Mail. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from two donors. The first is from the estate of Mary Emigot of North York, Ontario, in memory of Mary and for the intentions of her daughter, granddaughter, and family. The second is an anonymous donor from Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island, in memory of her husband, Stephen. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like St. Lawrence Rouge and 26 of his companions did, Japanese martyrs, knowing that all wisdom comes from God and all courage comes from God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, we pray, Lord God, the same perseverance shown by your martyrs, St. Lawrence Rouge and his companions, in serving you and their neighbor, since those persecuted for the sake of righteousness are blessed in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Haggai. In the second year of King Darius, in the sixth month, on the first day of the month, the word of the Lord came by the prophet Haggai. Thus says the Lord of hosts, these people say the time has not yet come to rebuild the Lord's house. Then the word of the Lord came by the prophet Haggai, saying, is it a time for you yourselves to live in your paneled houses while this house lies in ruins? Now therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, consider how you have fared. You have sown much and harvested little. You eat, but you never have enough. You drink, but you never have your fill. You clothe yourselves, but no one is warm. And you that earn wages to put them into a bag with holes. Thus says the Lord of hosts, consider how you have fared. Go up to the hills and bring wood and build the house, so that I may take pleasure in it and be honored, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord takes delight in his people. Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in its maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let them praise his name with dancing, making melody to him with tambourine and lyre. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people. He adorns the humble with victory. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy on their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is glory for all his faithful ones. The Lord takes delight in his people. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Herod, the ruler, heard about that Jesus had all about Jesus had done, and he was perplexed, because it was said by some that John had been raised from the dead, by some that Elijah had appeared, and by others that one of the ancient prophets had risen. Herod said, "John I beheaded, but who is this about whom I heard such things?" And Herod tried to see Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's about as short as a Gospel reading can get. But today's readings, they're very much about faith and politics. And I'm not allowed, as a religious, I'm not allowed to run for office. But we cannot separate the two, although a lot of people say you got to separate politics and faith. But to be a person of faith means we have to speak out to injustice especially. And so this little gospel reading is actually beautiful, how it is placed between that Jesus is sending out 12 apostles, and right after that, the feeding of the 5,000. And we just have that little snippet in there. Herod is wondering. Like a good dictator, they always have to wonder what is going on. And a good dictator doesn't want anyone criticizing him or anything like that, or pointing to certain faults. They want to get rid of people. And so Herod is wondering. Likewise, in the first reading of Haggai, there is this thing with faith and politics. The people have come back from exile in Babylon. They have come back. And there's this thing about rebuilding the temple. But there's also a fair bit of opposition. There's some intrigues of the Sumerians, and of course political changes in Persia under Darius I, that there was more freedom. And so Haggai and Zechariah, they're very much pushing to get the temple built. But it was not that they rebuilt the temple right after the exile. There was an 18-year lull in rebuilding that temple because of political intrigue and people saying things and doing things, and it gets difficult. Today, likewise, we remember St. Lawrence Roos and companions, 26 companions who were martyred between 1633 and 1637, a four-year period. And St. Lawrence, he was actually from Filipino-Chinese heritage. He was married, 3 children, and he was very much a clerk. He was a clerk at one of the churches, a Dominican church, and he was actually, well, he lived out his faith quite well. But there was again intrigue. A Spaniard had been killed, and the finger was pointed to St. Lawrence. So he escaped he joined, shall we say, 3 Dominicans on a boat to Japan, just to kind of escape all this trouble and hopefully not get killed for it. But so he escapes to Japan, and Japan actually was closed, very much, again, political. They were very much afraid of the Spaniards. The Spaniards were very much established in the Philippines already, and Japan wanted to stay sovereign. So anyone, a foreigner, should not be there, and especially anyone who is preaching religion, because they were seen really as spies for the Spaniards. And so upon arriving in Japan, they were arrested, and eventually they were marched to Nagasaki for execution. But extreme tortures. We cannot comprehend the tortures they went through. And one of the favorite was, and that's how St. Lawrence Roos died, was hanging upside down in a pit. And hanging upside down, if I understand right, they would make two little slits above the eyes, so you would not go unconscious. There would be some blood dripping, and you'd be hanging upside down, one arm free, so you could recant your faith. Just had to stick up your arm. And obviously, he did not stick up his arm. And it's reported that he said, "I am a Catholic and wholeheartedly do accept death for God. Had I 1,000 lives, all these to him shall I offer." And he died after about 2 days hanging upside down in a pit. Cannot imagine the agony he would have gone through. But again, he was caught up in this politics. The missionaries were caught up in the politics, and someone had to pay the price. And this is, like I said, the story of the church. And it just continues in today's world with the persecutions. It's very hard to find numbers on people killed. But on average, about, to some sources, 13 Christians a day are being killed because of their faith. 12 churches are being attacked daily. And according to this source, about 5 Christians are abducted every day for ransom. And we just have to look at the news, how you know, Pakistan, India, China, Nicaragua, North Korea, and it just goes on and on and on. But it's always about, there's a political agenda behind it. Even in, for instance, in India, with the Modi government, there's a political agenda that Christians Christianity should be made difficult. And just recently, we had, of course, Nicaragua, where a Jesuit university was shut down, the Central American University, was shut down. Why? Because they harbored some protesters against President Daniel Noriega, who becomes more and more of a dictator, and who has exiled a few priests and so on, I believe a bishop too. But it's about that political agenda and having control. And this goes right through our history, through the church history. There's always a political agenda involved. And to be a person of faith, we have to read the newspaper, so to speak. We have to be in touch with what's happening in the world. And we have to also speak up and point out what is against our faith and what is about justice. Just here in North America, the whole thing about protection of life from conception to natural death. The abortion issue, of course, the end of life. I call it assisted suicide, but to put it politely, the whole maid thing in Canada, that where people can say, oh, I just want to make an end to it. And so that might seem on the surface very nice, but it's a slippery slope. A slippery slope because it's very convenient if someone, especially in the end of life, where it is very expensive to keep someone alive, the medical costs go way up. And so when someone is willing to press the button, that will save a lot of money. It's usually about money. Also, but it's a slippery slope because we can also, the next thing what's going to happen or might happen is, oh, you are, I'm just saying, you are 83 years old and you're not doing too good. You might still have a few years to live and we'll just make an end to it. And government sanctioned end to it. It's very dangerous stuff. And so that's why, for instance, here in North America, we really have to speak up about protection of life from conception to natural death. And especially at the end of life, things can get very expensive. And we have to, and as Christians, we cannot ignore it. The same that the government, it's legal for me to go have a smoke a joint and to take drugs. It's legal. But is it good for us? We have to speak up and point out that there's a more healthy way of living out the faith. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in the daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those suffering from an addiction, for those in recovery, and for those seeking healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those trapped in the evil of modern-day slavery, for all who work to help these people and to increase the number of those willing to get involved to bring an end to human trafficking. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for political prisoners around the world who had the courage to speak out against abuse of power. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
That humble spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give a door to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Glory be yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
and let us offer each other a sign of peace. The Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that, drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ, and labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
Gather each day.